Hello everyone, welcome to the class. Today in this video, I am going to discuss trigonometry. Trigonometry is a Greek word in which tri means three, gono means sides or we can say angles, and metri means measurement. Metri means measurement. So what will be the definition of trigonometry? The measurement of three angles or three sides of a triangle is known as trigonometry. Now trigonometry can only be used in a right angled triangle. Right angled triangle is what? A triangle in which one angle is of a 90 degree and other two angles here will be acute angles. Let's name this triangle as A, B and C. This is right angle triangle. Trigonometry will be used only in right angle triangle. Now, as you have studied in previous classes, Pythagoras theorem, where we have perpendicular square plus base square is equal to hypotenuse square. Now, in this triangle, what will be the hypotenuse? Hypotenuse is always the side that opposite to the right angle. So it will be hypotenuse. But now question comes, which side will be base and which side will be perpendicular? So adjacent side except hypotenuse, because hypotenuse is fixed, adjacent side except hypotenuse will be base. And opposite side to angle, opposite side will be perpendicular. For example, if we take this angle, angle B, if angle B is taken, then what are two adjacent sides? This and this. But we know it is hypotenuse. So what will be base? The side AB will work as base and side AC, which is opposite to this angle, will be perpendicular. So it is perpendicular, it is base. This is base, this is perpendicular. But if we take this angle, then adjacent sides are BC and CA. So this is hypotenuse. So this will be base if we take angle at C, and this will be perpendicular, which is opposite to angle C. Now after this, we have ratios of the sides. Ratios of sides: P upon H, perpendicular upon hypotenuse; B upon H, base upon hypotenuse; and P upon B, perpendicular upon base. These are three possibilities, and there are another three possibilities also which will be opposite of this all three: H upon P, H upon B and B upon P. But commonly we will see these three. Now there comes another term named trigonometric ratios. Trigonometric ratios. What are trigonometric ratios? Trigonometric ratios are relationships between the angle and ratio of sides of a right angled triangle. For example, we have an angle sine theta. Sine theta, or we can see sine B. If we take this term, then angle will be sine B. Or if we name this as theta, then it will be sine theta. Sine theta, cos theta, tan theta. These are three commonly used trigonometric ratios. Sine theta will be equal to, where we have angle and relation with ratios of sides, which will be P upon H. Cos theta will equal to B upon H, and tan theta will equal to P upon B. These are trigonometric ratios. But there are three another trigonometric ratios which are equal or opposite. We can say sine theta is reciprocal of cosecant theta, or cosecant theta is reciprocal of sine theta. Cos theta is reciprocal of secant theta, or secant theta is reciprocal of cos theta, and tan theta is reciprocal of cot theta. These are six trigonometric ratios. So here, what will be cosecant theta? Cosecant theta will be H upon P. and secant theta will be h upon b and cot theta will be b upon p. Okay, here we can see that tan theta is also equal to sin theta upon cos theta. So what will be cot theta? Cot theta will be equal to cos theta upon sin theta, because it is reciprocal of this. So this is relation, and these are six trigonometric ratios we have. Now after these all trigonometric ratios, I will give you a trick to remember these six trigonometric ratios. For example, P upon H. So P, B, P, H, H, B. Pandit Badri Prasad Har Har Bole. What? Pandit Badri Prasad Har Har Bole. P upon H sin theta, B upon H cos theta, and P upon B tan theta. P upon H, B upon H, P upon B. Pandit Badri Prasad Har Har Bole. You can remember these and calculate cosecant theta using sin theta, secant theta using cos theta, and tan theta or cot theta using each others. Or you can calculate tan theta and cot theta using sin theta and cos theta. Now question comes, what is a practical use of trigonometry? Why we should study trigonometry? Because you can use trigonometry to calculate heights of big towers or buildings. You can use trigonometry to calculate width of a river or height of a plane flying at some certain height. Using trigonometry, where you know only one thing, that is base or height or hypotenuse and one angle. So using one side and one angle, you can calculate other sides and angles of a triangle. Okay, but you can't use Pythagoras theorem. As I told you, Pythagoras theorem is also used in right angle triangle, but in Pythagoras theorem you have to be aware with any two sides of triangle. For example, if you know base and perpendicular, you can calculate hypotenuse. If you know hypotenuse and base, you can calculate perpendicular. But in trigonometry, it is easy to calculate other two angles or other two sides. But using Pythagoras theorem, we can't calculate other two angles. But using trigonometry, we can. So I hope you understood this lecture on trigonometry. Thank you. Goodbye.